In this video, I'm showing you how to write the implementation subsection step by step. Let's look at part 2. In the investigation conclusions, we know that the proposal of maintaining indoor temperature at 25.5 degrees Celsius is being chosen. This is the one. That means this is the proposal to be chosen. And why your boss would like to choose this proposal? Due to the reason of effectiveness and ease of implementation. And for the implementation details, here you are. So in order to let you refer to the details easily, I move the prompts to this page. So let's start. First of all, you need to tell the reader which proposal is finally chosen. So you will put maintaining indoor temperature. You will put maintaining indoor temperature. The proposal of maintaining indoor temperature at 25.5 degrees Celsius be chosen. It's up to you. Do you should or without should? Okay. Next, among the three proposed zones, this one is the, okay, let's refer to the considerations. Effectiveness, ease of implementation. Please change them to the adjectives. We need the adjective. So effectiveness. So I will change it to the most effective, because you are making a comparison among three things. So we need to use the most. This is in the superlative form. I've also compiled a list of considerations for your reference. In case if you see the word feasibility, change it to the most feasible. Cost, cost effectiveness, the adjective form should be cost effective or economical. Never say the cheapest. Manpower, so we change it to require the least manpower. Energy efficiency, change it to the most energy efficient. Prospects, so you would say it has the best prospect. So this is a list of considerations. Let's move on to talk about the implementation details. So first paragraph of the implementation details is usually about budget. Sometimes it would be about manpower. So this time it's about manpower. A team. Adjusting temperature. Here means a team is required to help to adjust the temperature to 25.5 degrees Celsius. So we put to implement the recommended proposal. A team should be or will be what is the verb? We form a team, right? So formed. A team should be or a team will be formed to adjust the temperature. Okay, Try to do a little bit more elaboration. Adjust the temperature of all the air conditioners. Where? In the estate. Next point. Next point would be about a time frame. So the time frame is by July. By July. But what should be done by July? Oh, this is the adjustments. Here, adjustments mean the temperature adjustment. Adjustments of the temperature. Is expected to begin. Adjustments to begin. Okay, so we say to begin. For certain verbs, we will never use the passive. Begin, start. They are the examples. We never say something is begun or something is started. Begin and start should be used in the active voice. Second paragraph is to talk about how to make the proposal more convincing or more effective. Recommended action to make the proposal more convincing. So what should be done? It is suggested that conduct a survey. Conduct a survey. So who conduct a survey? If you have no idea who conduct a survey, why don't you use the passive? So you say, a survey. B, conduct. After a 1 month trial during summer. So what is the survey for? The survey is for collecting feedback. A survey for collecting feedback. B, conduct. Okay, so this part is the elaboration. So the next two paragraphs will be about concern. So let's look at the concern. So the concern number one is resistance from residents. Another one is grievance from staff. So for these two points, they are in the noun phrase. So you can just copy and paste to this part. To address concern about the resistance from residents. Another one, grievance from staff. So what is the solution? The solution is organize briefings for residents. Organize briefings for residents. So I've changed the word organize into ing form to make it become a noun phrase. Never use the verb organize here because one sentence contains only one verb. If you use organize, it is a verb, but it's also another verb here. So that's why you have to change it to a noun. So organizing briefing to residents is proposed, or you can say would be a good idea. And the result is gain acceptance of proposal. So in order to gain acceptance, whose acceptance? Residents. So I say so that they will accept this proposal. So the last paragraph will be about another solution to deal with the concern. So the concern is about grievance from staff. So let's see the solution. The solution is to adjust temperature on extremely hot day. So again, use the passive. The temperature level be adjust on extremely hot days. How about the result? The result is reduce complaints. Whose complaints? Of course, the complaints from staff. Hence, or you can say thus, or therefore, complaints from staff could be reduced. Okay, let's check. To deal with the issue of grievance from staff, if you really use this structure, it is necessary, it is advisable. After to, we need to use a verb. Okay, so now I need to change it. It is necessary to adjust. The temperature on extremely hot days. Hence, complaints from staff could be reduced. In this way, it is optimistic that the issue could be addressed. Okay, for the last sentence, it's up to you to keep it or not. Okay, so here comes the implementation succession. So to recap, altogether, there are 5 paragraphs. The first paragraph is to tell the reader which final proposal is chosen. And this paragraph is to talk about the date or manpower together with a time frame. Next is talk about the action to make the proposal more convincing. And the last two paragraphs will be about the solutions to deal with the concern. Good luck to your implementation succession. In next video, I'll be talking about elaboration on benefit.